Welcome to Kettle Run, an Ultimate General Civil War, where I'm playing the Union campaign. I'm Major General Difficulty with the JMP mod. We can take 9 units to the battle, and I have both of my 2nd and 3rd Corps commanders as my division commanders as I'm trying to get them the Major General. AI unit scaling is set at the base of 1 for this battle. I'm sure that I'm not the only one that doesn't really care for this battle much. Fighting uphill, in the dark, out in the open is never a very good idea. Plus, you must take the VP before the mission timer expires, and I tend to like to fight at my own pace. I often use the side battles to get XP from my lowest units, or those units that are closest to getting their next star. However, at Kettle Run, it never works out very well, so I tend to take my better units into this battle. You may find that using a Corps commander with a speed perk to be helpful if you're having trouble taking the VP on time. Any units with speed perks can also be helpful, since not only do they cover ground faster, but unit condition doesn't degrade as much, so you won't have to rest them as long between movements up the hill. If you come in from the left side along the river, you can find some cover, but the enemy will also be in cover, and his artillery will be in a superior position to yours. So when going that way, it's best to try to bait his units to charge out of their own cover. If you have speed perks and horse artillery, you may find success going up the far right of the screen and getting into position on the higher ground before you start your offensive, but you'll run up against the timer that way. Another issue that you can come into on the far right is that your artillery may not be able to target some enemy units due to being on the right side of the crest of the hilly area along the center of the battlefield. The battle starts at 4:03 in the morning, and the very limited visibility is best around the upper crest of the hill towards the center of the screen. So my guys are going to come in a little to the right of the crest to get set up, making sure to stop to recover condition along the way. My cav and 3-star skirmisher will go up the far right and then along the north, because this will give them the best position for spotting. Coming in from the right side of the crest also negates the CSA from using his cover early in the battle. However, you will see that my artillery still has trouble targeting at times due to the terrain. Once they are to the left of the crest of the hill, that issue goes away. With 1:34 left on the mission clock, you will see that I tell Schweitzer, my 20-pound Parrot battery, to target the enemy artillery, and I get the message in the upper right that says Schweitzer is moving to fire at the target. You may have to hit the pause button to notice that there are 2 arrows on the red line from Schweitzer to the enemy artillery. The end of the first arrow tells me how far Schweitzer needs to move up to get into position to fire. In this case, that will be just to the left of Loomis's infantry brigade. You'll see the same double red arrow numerous times in this battle. Some enemy units will be able to be targeted with my guns, and some won't until I move them. I will eventually push the CSA to the left side of the river. I wish I could tell my guys not to fire on enemy supply wagons, but I don't believe that is possible, so I need to turn off firing briefly until they get a better target. Enjoy the battle, and I'll comment at the battle report at the end. I lost just under 7% of my forces here, and the AI lost 71% of its forces, giving me an 18-1 kill ratio. My skirmishers led the score sheet in kills, and I also captured about a brigade's worth of Lorenz rifles. The Dixon, Nelson, and Company M1841s have a range of 440 yards, so my skirmisher units will be using those. I need to get set up for Second Bull Run, so I hope to see you there.